Welcome to all the viewers and the legal fraternity and all the viewers from the Parul Institute of Law, Parul University. I am Dr. Rajesh Singh, Associate Professor from Parul City the moderator of this event. The topic of this webinar is the bail provision in the courts of India, and our distinguished speaker are Advocate Renu Kochar and Advocate Rahil Kochar from Chhattisgarh High Court. I warm welcome both of the dignitaries at our Parul Institute of Law. First of all, I will just have a short description about the two guest speaker. About Renu Kochar, she has done law from the Rani Durgavati University, Jabalpur. Enrolled as an advocate on 6-9-2000. She has been practicing in the Chhattisgarh High Court and with Arun Kochar advocate, ex-member Chhattisgarh State Bar Council, and deal with various branches of the law, especially the criminal and the civil law. Counsel for the Central Exercise Chhattisgarh Electricity Board Education Society. She has experience of 20 years in the High Court and practice in the subordinate courts also. Now about the Rahil Kochar, he has graduated in the law from R.N. Patel Ipkowala School of Law and Justice from Sardar Patel University, and he is right now working as an independent attorney in the chamber of Sri Arun Kochar, who is a very renowned advocate at Chhattisgarh High Court. He is a litigator in the High Court of Chhattisgarh, and as well as he has also argued in the various matter at Gujarat High Court. He is dealing with the civil, criminal and the constitutional matter, and having the head law's office at Bilaspur, and which is associated in the Raipur and Ahmedabad also. So I warm welcome both the speaker on this webinar. So it is really a fantastic, ma'am, and sir both have given a time and spare a time for us, Parul Institute of Law and Parul City. Let me introduce our Dean, Dr. Akhil Sayed. He is a very young and dynamic leader at our Parul City. Secondly, he has done his doctorate from Gujarat National Law University, from Gandhinagar. Thirdly, that he is having 6 research projects. He is working on that, and already few books, 6 books have already published in the name of Dr. Akhil Sayed. He is contributing every aspect at the Parul Institute of Law, and he is emphasized on the totally on the development of the Parul Institute of Law. And so, sir, I will just request Dr. Akhil Sayed, sir, to warm welcome our both speaker, Dr. Akhil Sayed, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Rajesh. Madam Shri Mati, Renu ma'am, Sadar Pranam. It's our great pleasure that a renowned lawyer from the bench of Chhattisgarh is here. Bar of Chhattisgarh is here at the Parul Institute of Law, Parul University. It is our great pleasure and privilege to listen you on this auspicious webinar. And at the same time, I congratulate Mr. Rahil also in this very young age, he has earned so much credentials. I learned from Rajesh that how much successful he had been as an advocate also. Ma'am, ours is a very recent university, was been established in 2015, and Law Institute got established in 2016. Since then, we have started with 3 integrated program, namely BLLB, we do offer LLM in 6 different specializations. That is what we do, have 1 year PG LLM program. And we also run so many PG other courses, MPhil, and apart from MPhil and PhD, several certificate and diploma courses. Ma'am, it's a great pleasure that you are here with us, and I am very much tempted to listen so many things, because I also practiced before the court for nearly a decade, and this was an area in which whenever we prepare, a lawyer also whenever prepare feels that yes, he had to he was in need to do something more so that his bail could be granted or may succeed in the case. So for the student, I am sure that today's this webinar is going to be definitely very much fruitful and useful. Thank you for being us. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Now, Dr. Rajesh Singh, this topic is very interesting because, you know, the bail provisions generally, when you are arguing before the Honorable Court and before the Session Court and before the High Court, the specific grounds are very much mandatory and very much important while arguing before the courts. So, from this, I warm welcome both of the speaker, and I handing this webinar to Renu ma'am so that she can elaborate this topic, and then I will ask Rahil to speak on this topic. So I am just handing over to Renu ma'am. Renu ma'am, to you ma'am.
Thank you very much, sir. It's a very warm welcome given by you, Lord. Today my topic is the bail, provision of bail and development in courts of India. It's a very interesting topic. For that, I'll divide my topic into six parts. First, the concept. What is the concept of bail? Then, what is bailable offence? What is non-bailable offence? Then, 438, where how an anticipatory bail is given. Then, the interim bail, and what is the default bail, and bail, how it is given in parole. So, firstly, what is the concept of bail? How it is derived? The institution of bail is like any other branch of law, has its own philosophy. To understand, we have to see the various development which has taken place. In ancient time, in the law, crime rate was very low. The justice delivery system was very fast. The trial used to be concluded within 1 or 2 days. So the concept of bail was not known to at that time. And with the passage of time, the justice delivery system was delayed. And at this point, then the development of law took place. It was thought that a person cannot be kept behind the bar for a long period until he has been proved guilty. With this aspect, the provision of bail was came into force, that it cannot be assumed that a person can be kept behind the bar for the assumption that at the end of the trial he may be proved guilty. So the Webster's has defined bail. Bail is a security given for the due appearance of a prisoner in order to obtain his release from imprisonment. A temporary release of a prisoner upon security, one who provides bail. So it's a security given by the accused that he will be present before the court whenever the trial commences. With the British rule in India, the common law of rule was introduced in India. Such common law introduced by bail had its statutory recognition in Code of Procedure of 1861. Then it was followed in the Criminal Code of Procedure in 1872, further in 1898. The Law Commission of India, in its 41st report on the Code of Criminal Procedure, has sought to streamline the procedure aspect of bail, keeping in view the administrative law and justice have mandate to function in a manner so that constitutional equilibrium between freedom of a person and interest of the social order are maintained effectively. The Law Commission has also recognized bail as a matter of right if the offense is bailable, but it is a matter of discretion if the offense is non-bailable. It was recommended that bail is not granted if an offense is punishable with death or imprisonment of life, but the court has direct discretion in a limited cases to order release on bail respect of those offenses also. So it is the in a bail non-bailable offense, it is the discretion of the court. He has to consider various aspects while granting the bail. Bail is a rule. Jail is exception. It is a legal principle was laid down by the Supreme Court in landmark judgment of State of Rajasthan versus Balchand reported in 1978. The judgment was based upon several rights that have been granted by the Constitution of India, with Article 21 being the most important one. Detention of an individual infringes his right of life and liberty as granted under Article 21 of the Constitution. The main purpose for detention is to ensure easy proceeding by availing the accused for the trial without any inconvenience. Thus, if it can be ensured that the accused will be available as and when required for trial, then detention of the person is not necessary. So the basic idea behind was that a person should assure that he will be present before the court whenever the trial commences. And for that, it was not necessary that he should be detained. These aspects has to be considered by the court. The various section of CRPC provide statutory right to detain individual or individuals apprehending detention. One such right is as bail. It is a provisional release of a detained person who is accused of crime and the judgment is yet to be delivered. The term bail has been derived from French verb bailer, which means to give and to deliver. Bail is granted keeping in mind the objective behind arrest, which is to ensure the presence of accused before the court for the trial without any inconvenience. However, if the presence of the accused can be guaranteed without detaining the person, then it would be unjust to violate his right to liberty. Therefore, bail is a form of a security deposit to appear before the court for release. Now, bail as such has not been defined in CRPC, but in section 2A of CRPC, bailable offense and non-bailable offense has been defined. As per section 2A, bailable offense means offense which is shown as bailable in first schedule or which is made available bailable by any other law for the time being in force, and non-bailable offense means any other offense. So when a person is arrested for a non-bailable offense, for a bailable offense, he will move an application under section 436 of CRPC, and if it's produced before the court, then the court may grant him bail on his production of bail bond or surety. But there were many instances where the accused persons were detained in jail because they could not furnish surety, and there had been a leading case of Bihar, that is Hussaina Rani Khatun versus State of Bihar, AIR 97-1360, where an habeas corpus petition was filed because numbers of prisoners were detained in jail before trial, and as they could not furnish the surety, they were not released. So the court held that it will be unjust to keep a person because he is poor and he is not able to furnish the surety amount. So the concept of furnishing bond was involved, that the accused were released on bond on furnishing bail bond in bailable offense. Then further, 436A was inserted by amendment which came in effect from 23-6-2006, whereby three under trial prisoner other than one accused of an offense for which death has been prescribed as one of the punishment has been under detention for one half of the maximum period of imprisonment for alleged offense. He should be released on his personal bond with or without surety. It was also provided that in no case any under trial prisoner could be detained beyond the maximum period of imprisonment for which he can be convicted for the alleged offense. So the person cannot be convicted, kept behind the bar for n number of time, even because he has not been able to produce the surety. And there is a provision to this clause that court has a reason after hearing the public prosecutor, though the section 436 is mandatory that a person who files an application for bail for a bailable offense, then the court has to give the bail. But if the court finds that in the circumstances of the case, the bail is not, cannot be granted, then he has to hear the public prosecutor and he has to give a reason why the bail should not be granted, which should be rejected and it should not be granted because it's a mandatory. And then section 437 of CRPC and 439 of CRPC deals with bail for bailable offense, non-bailable offense, in which the accused is arrested and he has been arrested without warrant. He is produced before the court and the court can grant the bail. But there are exceptions. The court will not grant the bail if the person he is arrested in is of a heinous crime, the, in which the sentence can be of life or death, then the court may reject the application. And also in the cases when the court thinks that he has been already undergone, already convicted for the offense, which has been for life or more than once a 7 year sentence, then the court will reject the application. And the court has to see the prima facie case there is made out or not for releasing him on bail. The conditions has been given in section 437(3) of CRPC that the bail bond, the accused follows the bond which has been given to him, and then he will not involve in any other case of such kind. Then he'll not tamper with the witnesses and directly or indirectly involve in the case. So these are the conditions which court has to see by granting bail in a bailable or non-bailable offense. Then there is a provision in section 437 CRPC subsection 5 that a person can be, his bail application can be rejected if he does not follow section subsection 1 and 2 of section 437. And in section 437(6), there is a provision that a magistrate can, if the offense is trial by a magistrate and the trial is not completed within 60 days from the date of initiation of the evidence, then the court can grant the bail. Then further in 437(7), subrol 7, the court finds that before the judgment is delivered and the trial is concluded, the accused can be released on bail. The court has to see the circumstance that there is a reasonable ground that he may not be involved in the case. Then court will give the bail, but he has to assign the reason. Then coming to section 439, which is also offense in which non-bailable offense in which the accused is arrested by police and detained in police station, he can apply for the bail before session court or the high court, and the court can grant after considering the various aspects which is being given in section 437(3) while considering whether he'll be granted bail or not. The court can grant the bail, and court in subsection 1 of section 439, court can has a power, session court and the trial high court has power to reject his bail which has been already granted to him. Then now section 438 of CRPC, this was not there in CRPC in 1989. This has been brought in the amendment in the 41st report of Law Commission. It was thought that the fundamental right which has been granted to a person for life and liberty should not be curtailed, because there were many instances where, because of the political influences, the people was falsely implicated, or because of grudge, they were falsely implicated and the person had to remain in jail till the trial is concluded. Therefore, considering these aspects, this section was introduced in 1979 with the amendment in 438 is apprehension, and when an accused apprehends his arrest, that he will be arrested, then he moves an application before session court or high court. This is mandatory that only court which is given, only the high court and the session court has power to grant bail anticipatory bail. The anticipatory bail, this type of bail, when a person anticipates that he might be arrested for a non-billable offense, and then he moves before the session court or the high court. The conditions for which, by which the bail can be granted. When the investigation is not completed within the prescribed period, or there is a reasonable ground to believe that the accused has committed non-billable offense, then the court can grant them bail. Prima facie court has to see that there is evidence that he has been falsely implicated, then the court may grant him bail. It is a discretion of the court. It is not mandatory that the court has to grant the bail. Now, the application for bail, what it is necessary that there is some concrete evidence that there is a chances of his false implication, then the court grants bail. Just the general vague allegation, court will not entertain the application and grant the bail because he is apprehending that he might be arrested. So the basic requirement is that the court has to see that there are evidences, there are facts, concrete facts, which his by which his apprehension court thinks that there is chances of his arrest, then the court can grant the bail. Now the conditions are that he shall not make himself, he shall make himself available for interrogation by police officer as and when required. This is the condition mandatory. Then he will not tamper with the evidence and witnesses. Then person shall not leave India. These are the three conditions by granting bail and anticipatory bail the court and the session court has to consider. Only then the court gets anticipatory bail. There are kitten of judgment where the court, starting from Gurbakh Singh, this is the leading case whereby Honorable Supreme Court 1980 has laid down in this court that CRPs must be used very sparingly. Yes. However, the discretion of the court to grant bail cannot be limited just because the offense is punishable with life or imprisonment or the death penalty. Additionally, the court held that bail should not be limited by time. However, the court can impose certain reasonable restriction on the basis of the circumstances of the fact and case. So this is how the Gurbakh Singh had dealt with the keeping in view the section 21 of Constitution of India, that personal liberty should not be curtailed. Then came the case of Salaluddin Abdul Salam Saik versus State of Maharashtra in 95. This court overruled the judgment of Gurbakh Singh and held that the grant of anticipatory bail should be limited by time. The court held that anticipatory bail must be granted for a limited period, on the expiration of which the matter must be left to the regular court for decision. So the judgment of Gurbakh Singh was overruled. Then the issue came, issue was decided by Siddharaman Satyalingappa Mehta versus State of Maharashtra in 2000. In this judgment, Apex Court widened the scope of personal liberty with respect to arrest and grant of bail to a citizen. The Apex Court emphasized upon the importance of maintaining a balance between personal liberty and social interest. The court held that duration of anticipatory bail cannot be limited by time because there is no limitation set by any law. Therefore, the wide discretion has been conferred to the court to grant bail as per the facts of the case. Now, as there was a different views of the high courts, then the latest judgment of Honorable Supreme Court of 5 judges bench, which has been decided in Sushila Agarwal versus State of NCT Delhi and others, this issue has been dealt whether the limitation, there should be any limitation for the anticipatory bail or it should be arrested. This issue elaborately dealt by Honorable Supreme Court in 5 judges bench, and it's a landmark judgment. And in this court held that protection under section 438 of CRPC cannot be invariably limited to a fixed time. However, depending upon the facts of the case, the court may impose certain condition and time limit while granting bail. Additionally, the court held that the protection provided by an anticipatory bail does not end when the accused is summoned or charges are framed. It can be continued until the trial ends. However, if the circumstances of the case require a fixed time limit or imposition of certain conditions, then the court can impose the same. So the court was of the view that the fundamental right which has been granted by the Honorable Constitution of India in Article 21, that cannot be curtailed. If a person is being granted bail, then till the end of the trial, he would be in bail. But if the court finds that there are exceptional conditions, then court can restrict that limitation. And it all depends upon facts to facts of the case. So the anticipatory bail, the main mandate of anticipatory bail is that his personal liberty should not be curtailed. At the same time, social values, the society has to be considered. Now, there are differences between regular bail and what is anticipatory bail. Regular bail is filed under Section 439 of CRPC, and anticipatory is filed in 438 of CRPC. In this, the accused is arrested, and in anticipatory bail, it's before he is arrested. And anticipatory bail can also be granted when the FIR is not lodged, and he only anticipates that there are chances that he may be implicated in an offense, and he apprehends his arrest before an FIR is lodged. He can move before session court or the high court for grant of bail or releasing him in bail on his furnishing a bail bond or surety. Now, the bail, interim bail is granted between during the pendency of regular bail and anticipatory bail. Before anticipatory bail is decided and a regular bail is decided, bail is given for a limited period. It's a very short period, and until the bail application is decided, the bail is given. Depends. Now, apart from these, the bail is also given in parole. Parole is the prisoner's release. However, his quantum of sentence remains intact, which means in case of violation of parole condition, a parole can be cancelled and the prisoner can be brought back to the prison. It is important to note that parole is not a right, rather it is a privilege given to the prisoner so that they can reinstate in the social environment and fulfill their duties and responsibility as a citizen. So parole is given so that the person can adjust in the society. Parole is not included under Section 432 of CRPC, which deals with suspension and remission of sentence. As per judgment of Honorable Apex Court in Sunil Phulchand Saha versus Union of India, parole does not amount to suspension of sentence, thus leaving it open the scope of Section 432 to CRPC. It deals with under Prison Act 1890 and Prison Act 1920. So there is a special provision. If the conduct of the accused is found to be good, the court releases him on parole, that is for a limited period. And this provision is dealt in Prisoner Act and of 1894 and 900. This provision is not dealt in CRPC. All the convicts, except for convicts who are foreigners and threat of to a national security, committed an offense against the state, convicted for more than one murder or convicted for rape or murder of a child, shall be eligible for parole. The aforementioned verdict might get parole at the discretion of the authorities. So it's the discretionary power of the authorities. It's not mandatory that if a person is behind the bar, then he has to be released on bail. It is the discretion upon the authorities whether they would be released on bail or not. Then there is regular parole. Regular parole is granted for a maximum of 1 month, except in the case special circumstances to the convict who have served the either 1 year of imprisonment is granted in their special situation like death in the family, marriage of a family member, there's a delivery of child by the wife, the convict, accident or seriousness, maintenance, social ties, damage due to natural calamities. These are the various aspects when a regular parole can be granted. Then there is a custodial parole. Custodial parole is granted in emergency situation like death of a family member, marriage of a family, serious illness, etc. It is granted maximum for 14 days and the prisoner cannot file for regular parole or custodial parole for next 1 year after the time period of parole has expired. So parole, a prisoner can apply for parole only once in a year, and once it is granted, then on the second year only he can apply. Even if there is a situation, he cannot apply for it. But if now because of the pandemic, the persons who has been released, they have been extended, the bail parole has been extended. In the special circumstances, the court thinks that because of pandemic like prison situation, the persons who have been released on bail, they are still on parole and their parole has been extended by the court. Now, default bail. Default bail is granted under section 172 of CRPC. 167.2 of the CRPC. The maximum period which a judicial magistrate can grant custody of a accused in the course of investigation is 90 days for offense punishable with not less than 10 years and 16 days for offense punishable with less than 10 years. Thus, if the investigation is not completed within a stipulated period of time, the magistrate will no longer be competent in the course of investigation to send the accused into custody. So the magistrate has power to grant. He cannot keep accused for more than 90 days in a case of non-bailable offense. He has to grant him bail if the investigation is not completed within 90 days. And in case of bailable offense, if the investigation is not completed within 60 days, then the court has to release him on bail. This is because of the default on the part of the prosecution who has not completed the proceeding investigation. Then the magistrate has to release him on bail. Now, because of the pandemic situation, Supreme Court has held in the case of G. Gyan Chand in S. Khasi versus State. This situation arose. A court held that though the looking to the contrary view and observed that holding held by the Supreme Court orders and inapplicable to the time period of filing and final report amounting to mocking the apex court. He also held that period of limitation for investigation under section 167 of the CRPC would stand extended, keeping in view the extraordinary situation of COVID-19. So looking to the pandemic situation, now the investigation is not being completed within 90 days or 16 days. Therefore, the accused cannot be released on bail because the special reason, the pandemic, the investigation is not being carried on because everywhere there is a lockdown. So the time period has been extended. And because as the trial is not, the investigation is not completed within 90 days, therefore the time is extended. Now, there are various conditions where